idea what it is, but then it'll power up and it'll show a set point and an actual reading of the temperature inside the box. So once the unit's on, to the left, it's going to be the set point, and it says set point right underneath. To the right is the actual temperature inside the box. So when the driver picks it up, he goes and gets loaded, it says 0 and 30. That's what it is inside the box. You have a power switch right here. So if you're not getting power to the unit, the breaker on the genset's flipped to the on position. You need to make sure the power switch is on. If you're not getting power to the unit, it could be the power switch. So the power switch is always be on. So that's something we get fairly often. The driver's not having the switch will be off and the unit's not getting power. Another thing we have is temperature. So you got your set point, change the temperature. Like I said, they want us to set their temps and all that. So the up and down arrows control the temperature. So if you want to change the temperature, just go up or down to where you want it, hit the enter button, and it'll lock the temperature in. If you do not hit the enter button, go into the button for 10 seconds, it'll go back to the original set point that it was set at. Another problem we have with temperatures is the driver will set his box to 34 degrees. Not 3.4. Other than that, that's the basic rundown on the startup, how to change the temperature, two types of gensets that we run, breaker, power, and the power switch, the reefer unit. We only run carrier reefers, so every reefer we have will look just like this, 45s and 40s. So there should be no problems, everything's the same. That's the basic rundown on it. If you guys have any questions about anything?
Prime in the reefer?
That's another thing we're gonna go over. Kathy's gonna get with us and we're gonna make a video.